TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Surbhi Sharma. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Monday, the 27th of January. Indian government invites bids to sell 100% stake in debt-laden airline Air India. Prominent Pashtun activist Mansoor Pashtin arrested in Pakistan. And Agni Sapkota sworn in as Speaker of Nepal's Parliament. And now for all the details. The Indian government has invited bids to sell entire stake in the country's flag carrier airline, the Air India, for the second time after a failed attempt 2 years ago. The government on Monday described the financial position of the airlines as very fragile and said, investors can now turn the debt trap into a profitable venture by bringing operational as well as financial efficiencies.
The Indian government on Monday invited bids to sell 100% stake in Air India, the country's flag carrier airline, for the second time after a failed attempt in 2018. A document released by the Civil Aviation Ministry showed March 17 as the deadline for submission of initial expressions of interest and that any bidder must agree to assume $3.28 billion in debt plus other liabilities. Civil Aviation Minister Hardeep Singh Puri in a press conference called Air India's financial position very fragile and urged private investors to turn the debt trap into a profitable venture by bringing financial efficiencies.
Due to its accumulated debt of about ₹60,000 crores, the financial position could be described as very fragile indeed, and Air India currently could be regarded as, and has, I would think it can only be described as being under a debt trap. Any private investor can turn it around and make Air India a profitable venture by bringing operational as well as financial efficiencies.
Air India has about 9,400 permanent employees and 3,600 fixed-term contract staff, including 1,850 pilots and 4,600 cabin crew with benefits such as discount air tickets and pensions. Its employees protested against the 2018 sale attempt, and it was not immediately clear if they would also resist the latest effort.
India has intensified measures to check passengers for the life-threatening coronavirus, which has sparked worldwide concerns with 80 deaths and nearly 2,000 confirmed cases. A suspected case of coronavirus has been reported in India's Rajasthan province, following which the patient has been kept in isolation.
India has intensified measures to check passengers for the life-threatening coronavirus, with reports that more than 5 people have been hospitalized in the country with symptoms resembling the disease. A suspected case of coronavirus has been reported in northwestern Rajasthan province, following which authorities have directed that the patient be kept in an isolation ward. The patient has returned to India after completing medical degree in China. Suspected case of coronavirus was also reported in eastern Bihar province.
लेकिन अभी तक उस रोगी की जो स्थिति है बिल्कुल स्थिर है, कोई दिक्कत नहीं है, सामान्य रूप से है, इसका कोई अभी ट्रीटमेंट नहीं है और आइसोलेशन वार्ड में उसको रख दिया गया है। अब सैंपल जो है पूना चेक करने के लिए, टेस्ट करने के लिए भिजवा दिया गया है। दो रोज में शायद वो रिपोर्ट आ जाएगी, उसके बाद ये तय हो पाएगा कि वो कोरोना वायरस का रोगी है।
Meanwhile, as precautionary measure amid coronavirus outbreak in many countries, several airport authorities have established screening centers to report the identification of such cases to the health officials. Bhubaneswar Airport Authority also conducted a screening for incoming passengers at Biju Patnaik International Airport. India's Ministry of Health and Family Welfare said that no case has been reported in the country so far of the novel SARS-like coronavirus, a new virus that has killed 81 people in China.
Moving on, Scotland Friends for India, along with other right groups, recently held a demonstration in the United Kingdom to express their support to the Indian government for the Citizenship Amendment Act. They highlighted the religion-based citizenship law does not undermine the secular foundations of the country.
Members of Scotland Friends for India, along with other rights groups, gathered in Edinburgh recently to express their support to the Indian government for the Citizenship Amendment Act, or CAA. The demonstrators held placards highlighting that CAA does not discriminate between the citizens of India, including Muslims, and does not undermine the secular foundations of the country. The CAA paves way to Indian citizenship to Hindus, Sikhs, Jains, Parsis, Buddhists, and Christians who fled religious persecution from Pakistan, Afghanistan, and Bangladesh and settled in India on or before December 31, 2014.
We have come over here to dispel the various misinformation which has been spread around against India and against the Indian government and Narendra Modi about the relationship of the CAA. I'm here to say, please don't believe in any rumors. Please read up on the act and you'll know exactly where this has happened.
Bangladesh mein Hinduon ki jo persecution 71 mein hui hai, wo usko bayan nahi kiya ja sakta. To isliye main samajhta hoon ki pehli dafa isko address kiya Indian government ne aur ये बहुत अच्छा है कि ये अब सिटीजनशिप उनको देंगे और वो रिफ्यूजी कैंप से निकल के एक नॉर्मल इंडियन सिटीजन की तरह तालीम भी हासिल कर सकेंगे जॉब्स भी कर सकेंगे और टैक्स भी देंगे
Meanwhile, protests against CAA have also continued in parts of India since it was passed in December last year. People in the countries Assam and other northeastern provinces fear CAA would alter the region's demographic balance, resulting in loss of their political rights, culture and land. While protesters in other parts of the country see the new law as discriminatory against Muslims and the poor, most of whom do not have access to valid proofs of citizenship.
In news from Pakistan, Manzoor Pashtun, a prominent activist and leader of Pashtun Tahafuz movement, was sent to a 14-day judicial custody by a court in Pakistan's Peshawar on Monday. The social movement is known for its strident criticism of Pakistan's powerful military for alleged enforced disappearances and extrajudicial killings in Pashtun-dominated tribal areas.
Pashtun Tahafuz Movement or PTM chief Manzoor Pashtun was sent to a 14-day judicial remand by a court in Pakistan's Peshawar on Monday, local media reports said. Pashtun was arrested late on Sunday night from Peshawar over a case registered against him on January 18 under sections such as criminal intimidation, criminal conspiracy and sedition, reports suggested. Taking to Twitter, Mohsin Dawar, a senior PTM leader and member of National Assembly, said, "This is our punishment for demanding our rights in a peaceful and democratic manner." Rights group Amnesty International also tweeted that Manzoor Pashtun has been arbitrarily detained for exercising his freedom of expression and must be released immediately and unconditionally. PTM has a huge support base among Pakistan's ethnic Pashtuns. It rose to prominence in 2018 when it began a justice movement, blaming the Pakistani army for heavy-handed operations in Pashtun-dominated tribal regions. Pashtun has since led rallies across the country demanding justice for victims of enforced disappearances, extrajudicial killings and alleged torture while in custody of Pakistani security forces.
Journalists in Gilgit-Baltistan held a protest recently alleging administration of attempting to curtail media freedom on the directives of Pakistan. They alleged the authorities in Pakistan are piling pressure on the media persons to restrain them from reporting the real picture in the illegally occupied region.
Journalists in Gilgit-Baltistan recently staged a demonstration outside the Gilgit Press Club to denounce censorship by Pakistan, exploitation and delays in wage payments and allowances. Journalists allege that with the move to curb the freedom of press, Pakistan's authorities are piling pressure on the media persons to restrain them from reporting the real picture in the illegally occupied region and creating artificial job crisis. They said the journalists are victimized for mirroring the realities of the region. A protesting journalist alleged that more than 2,200 workers lost their jobs ever since Prime Minister Imran Khan's Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf came into power.
وفاقی حکومت پاکستان تحریک انصاف کے آنے کے بعد پاکستان بھر میں صحافیوں کے ساتھ استحصال کیا جا رہا ہے ان کے اظہار رائے کی آزادی کے اوپر غیر اعلانیہ سینسرشپ کی جا رہی ہے اور ان پر مختلف قسم کے پابندیاں عائد کی گئی ہے مختلف جو صحافتی ادارے تھے ان سے ورکروں کو دباؤ کے ذریعے نکالا گیا ہے اور جو میڈیا انڈسٹری ہے اس کے اوپر ایک مصنوعی قسم کا بحران پیدا کیا گیا ہے
جو میڈیا ہاؤسز ہیں جو میڈیا انڈسٹری ہے ان کے اوپر یہ پریشر ڈالا جا رہا ہے کہ آپ اپنے ملازمین کو فارغ کریں اس کا مقصد یہ ہے کہ جو عوام کے ایشوز تھے جو عوامی مسائل تھے ان کو اجاگر کرنے کے حوالے سے جو میڈیا کردار ادا کرتا رہا تھا جو معاشرے کے آنکھ کان ناک کے حوالے سے اس کو دبانے کے لیے وفاقی حکومت یہ اوچے ہتھ کنڈے استعمال کر رہی ہے
According to media reports, the climate for press freedom in Pakistan has been deteriorating as authorities restrict reporting through intimidation and other means. Pakistan ranks 142 out of 180 countries listed on Paris-based Reporters Without Borders World Press Freedom Index.
Moving on to news from Nepal. Nepal's President Bidya Devi Bhandari on Monday administered oath of office to Agni Sapkota, the newly elected Speaker of Nepal's House of Representatives. Sapkota, a standing committee member of the ruling Nepal Communist Party, was elected unopposed.
Nepal President Bidya Devi Bhandari on Monday administered the oath of office and secrecy to Agni Sapkota, the newly elected Speaker of House of Representatives, the lower house of parliament. A standing committee member of the ruling Nepal Communist Party, Sapkota, was elected unopposed in the parliament on Sunday despite widespread concerns over his involvement in a murder case. The post of Speaker had fell vacant in October last year after Krishna Bahadur Mahara resigned over attempt to rape charges. Mahara is presently in judicial custody in the case. Once a Maoist rebel leader, Sapkota is still under investigation for kidnapping and killing of Arjun Lama, a resident of Kavre in 2005, during the decade-long insurgency. The next hearing in the case against him is to be held on 5th of February.
A group of Afghan politicians and senior members of Chief Executive Abdullah Abdullah's campaign team at a gathering on Sunday criticized President Ashraf Ghani for impeding the peace process by introducing new conditions for a potential peace agreement.
Senior members of Afghan Chief Executive Abdullah Abdullah's campaign team and a group of politicians on Sunday criticized the presidential palace for impeding the peace process by introducing new conditions for a potential peace agreement. They accused Afghan President Ashraf Ghani of monopolizing power and the peace process at a gathering in Kabul. Abdullah later took to Twitter and said, "The peace process is not a monopoly. The palace cannot make unilateral decisions. The peace process must be inclusive and representative." Abdullah advocates for a less restrictive approach to the peace process, contrast to President Ghani's consistent demand for a ceasefire instead of a reduction in violence. The Taliban has stated they are open to a reduction in violence. In the latest, as new rounds of talks are underway between the US and the Taliban in Doha, Afghan government led by Ghani continues to insist on a ceasefire before the next step in the peace process.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude, the top stories once again. Indian government invites bids to sell 100% stake in debt-laden airline Air India. Prominent Pashtun activist Manzoor Pashteen arrested in Pakistan. And Agni Sapkota sworn in as Speaker of Nepal's Parliament. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.